Whether you're new to After Effects or a veteran, you should know the value of motion blur and when to use it and when not to. Here's a quick tip for making sure you don't forget to enable motion blur previewing and to also ensure that it's applied when you export your project. I have this text animation. Notice that motion blur is not enabled. When I enable it at the layer level, notice that you still can't see it in our animation. It looks exactly the same. The reason is because you have to enable motion blur previewing, which is this option here. If you're working away and under a tight deadline, you can imagine how easy it might be to remember to enable motion blur previewing. But there's a shortcut that will ensure this never happens. Open your preferences and navigate to previews. The option you're looking for is under composition switches. Make sure you enable automatically enable frame blending and motion blur rendering. With this enabled, motion blur previewing will automatically turn on whenever you enable motion blur at the layer level. Notice how motion blur previewing turns off and on when I toggle motion blur at the layer level. And the difference in how this text animation looks with and without motion blur previewing enabled is quite significant, as you can see. If you have multiple layers, which you no doubt will, motion blur previewing will engage if motion blur is enabled on any layer. And once you enable, automatically enable frame blending and motion blur rendering, you'll never have to enable it again, which is helpful. Having motion blur previewing enabled is especially important when you export straight to Media Encoder, bypassing After Effects exporting. You must have motion blur previewing enabled in After Effects in order for Media Encoder to apply motion blur to your layers, even if every single layer in your timeline has motion blur enabled. There are times when it will benefit you to disable motion blur previewing, such as when you have a heavy file and motion blur is slowing down RAM previews. But if you disable motion blur previewing, make sure you enable it before exporting through Media Encoder, or you'll get some unwanted results. To make sure you get the benefit and look of motion blur for your exports, enable automatically enable frame blending and motion blur rendering so you never forget to enable motion blur previewing again. And if you disable it for any reason, make sure to enable it before exporting to Media Encoder.